Shazam!
Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back to Underdeveloped here, and happy holidays to you all. Hope you're enjoying everything. Hope you're going to get good presents. Hope you guys are shopping for the ones you love, getting your gifts, getting your Christmas cards. You know what I mean? Got cool plans, because our plans aren't that great right now. We decided to torture ourselves because deep down we're masochists. And for the holidays, we already gave you two other movies that are like at least somewhat decent Christmas movies. But this one, we decided to go with something that our grandmothers would love. Hallmark Christmas movies. It doesn't even matter the movie that we're watching. This whole edition is called Surviving Hallmark Christmas Movies. So we're going to put ourselves through the ringer. We're watching two ones. We just kind of trudged through Amazon to find like the cringiest plots we could find. This movie is, what's it called again?
It's a Gingerbread Romance.
Oh my god, don't that freaking title just immediately like makes you cringe up, really? And yeah. Tia Mori's in this. If you know Tia Mori, she's from The Game, Twitches, Sister, along with her twin sister, Tamara Mori. So, you're a legend. So, the fact that she's doing this is kind of sad.
Very, very sad.
It's but she's not the only impressive. One. There's a lot of like notable TV actors and stuff that, you know.
Yeah, they do movies like this. Absolutely true.
But fuck it. Let's do it. Let's just get it. At least these are short, so.
Yeah, at least it's only 80 minutes of pain.
Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just get out the way. So this is like Buffalo. So there's like backwater cities, metropolitan areas. Yeah, this is like upstate. A lot of times they shoot a lot of these in Canada.
Not surprised.
I met people who worked on these kind of movies. Like DPs, camera operators and shit. Like, look how bright these are. These look like commercials.
They do. The lighting is so flat.
Oh, so bad to look at. These look like, I cannot tell the difference between these and commercials. I cannot tell the difference between this movie and a commercial. I really can't.
Hi, Mom.
Taylor, sweetheart. I hope it's not too late, but I want to catch you before we went to breakfast.
Oh, don't worry. I just got home.
Hi, honey. Merry Christmas.
Mm. Hi, Dad. Merry Christmas to you. So, how's Christmas in Singapore?
Hot and humid. Now that you see my Christmas sweater, I'm taking it off.
That thing is so bad, I can't help but to make this face.
I don't blame you. It's quite repulsive.
First off, they look it's repulsive. First off, they look the exact same when she was a kid. They're not aged.
They have not aged at all.
And they sound like robots. I feel like someone is behind that camera with a gun in their face. Say the line.
Your daughter mustn't suspect a thing. She needs to know you're okay.
Oh my god, they acting like they're a hostage.
Hi, daughter. How was your trip? Oh, really? That's great.
So it's like I'm in an alternate reality where everyone's secretly evil.
Sunny months, and the new condo complex is almost built.
Actually, it was partly about you.
Me.
Taylor, you've got a great eye. Your work is always cutting edge, and your projects always come in on time and under budget.
And your exposition is always nicely presented.
The board is considering you to head up our new Paris office.
Wow, that would be terrific.
We'll see what happens. But in the meantime, there's this project I need your help on.
I'm totally open and excited. What's the project?
Okay, so you know that we submitted a proposal for the new downtown redevelopment project.
Yes, but I thought Cressford had a lock on City Hall.
According to the mayor, we're currently his top choice.
Great.
In the meantime, we need to do everything that we can to up our public profile.
How can I help?
Well, the city's Christmas festival is coming up, and they're doing a gingerbread house competition to raise money for charity this year. We've got a spot in the contest, and I need you to represent our firm as our designer.
What? Why her?
You want me to design a gingerbread house?
Yeah.
As in gumdrops and candy canes.
A life-sized one. I mean, we're talking big.
Linda, I'm an architect.
What a colossal waste of time. Who would, in their right mind in the universe, would do that? A giant waste of money and resources on a life, on a fucking
life-size gingerbread house?
People,
this is a competition that would never exist anywhere.
Never. Like, people, like, this is some really rich.
Also, why are you making her do this? Why are you sending an intern for this crap? Seriously.
Can't rush art, Ray.
Just move it along, Rembrandt.
What's up, black people don't talk like this?
I've seen her on TV before.
And black people, when we walk around with this kind of music playing in the background,
she's a perfectionist too.
We see a real black Christmas movie like this Christmas.
Wow.
This Christmas will be very special.
Yes, sweetheart. Just a few more deliveries and daddy will be home.
You know, I think building a gingerbread house. Certainly better
than this. I haven't seen that movie. I already know it's better than this.
Not your typical gingerbread house.
I'm gonna smash my head into this chest right now.
This must be the cake for our Christmas party.
Sorry, guys. This whole thing is us gonna be complaining about this when this be over.
Of course it is.
Like, literally. That's all this movie's gonna be. God, we're not even 10 minutes into this.
You just smudged green icing all over my plans.
Sorry. Can't you just reprint your plans?
Can you just reprint your cake?
You just.
Sadly not.
You just fucking pulled
up. Have your Santa cupcakes in the van.
You just came out of nowhere and just put your stuff on top of her shit. You kidding me? What a douche.
What kind of sick sociopath wrote this? Is this written by AI? I mean, it's 20...
Maybe.
I mean, it's not... I mean, it's kind of old for that, but still, it feels like it.
It's you.
Oh.
Yes. How can I help you? Uh-oh. It's you. Brooke.
Well, someone's carrying a grudge.
Hide the cakes.
Look, I know we got off on the wrong foot the other day.
That's putting it mildly.
It's not that big of a deal, dude. Relax.
Told me to always be nice to customers. Hi, I'm Brooke. Welcome to Ray's.
Nice to meet you, Brooke. I'm Taylor.
How can I help you?
Are you Ray?
I'm Adam. I work for Ray. He's not here.
But you did make that amazing Christmas tree cake, right?
Yeah, that's all me.
And obviously, you have a lot of experience with baking. Cookies, icing, decorating.
My dad can make anything.
Ever make a gingerbread house?
Dad made a whole gingerbread village one year.
Hmm. And what about a giant gingerbread house? Big enough to stand in. Could you make one of those?
I'm not sure I understand.
I'm an architect, and I am representing my firm in the city's giant gingerbread house competition. Seeing that it needs to be 80% edible, I need a baker to team up with. And I am thinking that should be you.
Why 80% edible? Why that number?
But I don't have a lot of spare time.
But Dad, it sounds so fun.
The structural parts.
Don't you have homework to do? That table right there has got your name on it. All right, folks, here they are. Mm. We have to put the hooks on them before we can put them on a tree, okay?
But they are good to eat.
Hey, every year we have this argument. Gingerbread are for decorating, not eating.
You can't blame us for liking them. They're too yummy. It's just more proof your talents are going to waste at Ray.
Not all that again.
Oh, what, Daddy?
Yeah, why do you want to watch this scene again?
I just want to figure out if they're together or not.
This project may have not been my first choice, but I intend to make the best out of it.
Yeah, I know.
This movie, like, legitimately bringing out guttural emotions.
My dad can make anything.
Can I make a gingerbread house?
How you enjoy this movie so far? Are you caps?
It's a Christmas miracle.
Are you capsulated? I bet your mom watched this movie like this.
No, she doesn't actually. She watches everything she likes, regardless of how much she likes it, like this.
Come on, let's go look at the. Literally.
She always looks so disgusted whatever's on screen. It can be the best thing in the world to her, and she'll have that same disgusted look at her face.
Why?
There's Taylor.
It is so bizarre.
Hey.
Then how you know that she likes it then?
She tells me.
She said, this is great?
Yes. If she does not tell me, I cannot assume anything. Because she looks like she's having an awful time every time.
Well, that's how I'm like,
she's so confused with what's happening.
Well, you know what? That's exactly how
like this.
But it's exactly how I'm watching this movie, like this. That's exactly the reaction this movie's getting out of me. Send a happy new
year. We all know what is that? Plans for our gingerbread house. What?
I assume the design is something we come up with together.
Well, I am a professional architect. I think I know what I'm doing.
Really?
I mean, he would understand the materials you're building with better, so you probably should consult him.
But what is that supposed to mean?
Well, it's so modern. It looks like a 21st century gingerbread condo.
Yes, the good old Hallmark philosophy of city bad, small town good.
Cutting edge.
Christmas isn't about cutting edge. Christmas is about warmth and tradition.
I want this to be funny, but this is getting downright sad.
Yes.
I mean, it's fun kind of making fun of certain things, but it's almost anger-reducing how bad this is. It's like, dude. I just want to laugh at how bad this is.
This is depressing.
This is depressing.
We live in the same world where this exists.
This is depressing bad.
Yes. You know how Emma Stone was in Poor Things when she saw all the dying children? That's me right now. On the inside. Because I'm just too bored to bring it outside.
If you actually watched that movie.
Huge, colossal Christmas tree.
Actually, we got the small one this year.
What kind of Christmas tree do you have, Taylor?
That's small?
Well, actually, I don't usually have
one. I see he has the same tree philosophy as Clark Griswold.
We don't fit too well in that luggage.
But everyone way better movie than this.
Damn right.
Oh. Brooke, did you make that? That's beautiful.
Like, the tree's not gonna be, like, this high.
Mm-hmm.
It's a school project. I'm supposed to be making a Christmas diorama. But I'm kind of stuck on making the trees.
Do you want a little hint? You can make great tree trunks by wrapping sandwich twists in parchment paper. I made a lot of models when I was in architecture school.
Thanks.
Oh, sous chef, you're needed.
I think that means me.
And I have a hint too. When you cook with my dad, wear an apron, cause a lot of things splash.
Wish me luck.
Yo, I'm sorry, God. I can't imagine how my face is looking at this
camera.
I bet the new editing's gonna be a lot of me just going this.
The thumbnail will absolutely be you scowling.
Like, literally, I'm the scowling this fucking movie.
Your job is to keep track of time.
Oh, great. I'm doing the job of an egg timer.
Gingerbread batch number 2, I made with margarine instead of butter. And for our third experiment, I'm substituting corn syrup for molasses. This keeps the pastry from puffing out and maintains its shape. These are all variations of my mom's.
I get you, this actor doesn't speak American.
Little trick they don't
teach you. Yeah, he looks kind of British, to be honest.
Butter improves
actually, hold on. Let me actually fuck you.
But no one would.
Was it Gingerbread Romance?
Duane Henry, known for The Dark Knight Rises, Captain Marvel.
He was in those movies?
Yes, that's probably some of the really Oxford small murders. Roles,
because I don't remember seeing him.
He was born in Birmingham, UK. God, called it.
Makes sense.
Called it. He was British.
You do know they have powdered ginger.
Creativity and inspiration can't be rushed, okay? Rome wasn't built in a day, and our gingerbread house won't be either.
Clearly not if you're involved.
What a cringing line.
Wouldn't working with a recipe be more efficient?
I like to take my time. Let my creativity flow.
Sounds risky.
Maybe. But for every fallen souffle, there's a perfect profiterole tower.
You know, I'm really glad you're not an architect, because that approach would not pass inspection. Now remember, we don't want bricks. We need thin rectangles of gingerbread.
Why so thin?
Well, remember my design? It calls for thin pieces of gingerbread. I need for my design to be ultra sleek and modern.
But that'll make it more likely to crack.
Yeah.
Maybe use less butter?
And compromise taste and texture? What do you say we stop the backseat baking?
The fuck was the point of that?
I don't care, let's just move on. Let's just get this movie done.
Morning.
Don't give a fuck. This movie is over.
I wasn't expecting to see you so early.
Sorry, we were thinking we did a better job, but this movie just
always get
not it.
Well, this after yesterday's fiasco.
They feel free to follow their creativity.
As long as we meet certain benchmarks and construction.
I get it. She's a practical, technical one, and he's about passions. I get it. Whatever.
Staying on our own side. Because Hallmark always treats big city girls who are successful in their life as their unhappy and cold and have absolutely no sense of warmth or care.
Yep, and realize that hair is where all she needed to belong. Blah, blah, blah.
Because gender roles. Ha, ha, ha. These cheap bastards couldn't pay for a real Christmas song. Fuck you.
We'll take all the orange and red glass candy you've got. And can I get some gumdrops too? Sure, how many would you like? Maybe 5,000? No, 10,000. You sure about that, young lady?
Yeah, she's sure. She's the chief decorating officer after all.
Well, all right then.
That's the one that broke you.
That's a lot of ice.
That's the line that broke you.
Yes, that. Yes.
It was some of the lines that broke you.
Nice to meet you. What are you guys doing here? Oh, just delivering Brooke to her dad. Nice Christmas tree.
Oh, trying to decorate her crib.
Yeah.
What is everyone smiling about?
Follow me, Taylor.
What'd they do?
Ta-da!
Oh my god, it's so pretty! Oh, wow, I can't believe it!
Yeah, I told her to fuck you, because I just went through all the effort and money decorating some trick I barely know crib for Christmas.
Yep.
If that's not a clear indicator that I want to fuck you, then I don't know what if.
Dude. Oh. Okay, then do you want
one? Why are you wasting popcorn like that?
Popcorn decorations.
Oh. Okay, you're going to have a good look.
That's a thing?
No.
Good. Because that's a fucking waste.
It's beautiful.
It's hand-blown crystal.
It's beautiful.
My parents, they lived there for 2 years. They have an amazing Christmas market in old town. Sorry for calling so late, Taylor.
You're fired.
No, that's fine. Is everything okay?
More than okay. Listen, I appreciate how you've taken the reins with the competition.
Thank you.
Clearly, you've held up your end of our little deal.
Yep, so she's going to go away and take the deal. I'm going to take the early Christmas offer.
Present for you. Can you say Joyeux Noël?
What do you mean?
I had dinner with a few of our board members tonight, and, you know, they'll make a formal decision later, but...
You're the front runner for Paris.
Hey, look at it, look at it, look at it. It's a fucking generic fucking cover of the song.
Yeah. Not a popular version. Not a good version, no. Just something stock that you paid very little money for, if any.
Kiss. Oh my god, nobody can stop to the hood.
They can kiss each other's asses for all I care. Just working on our house.
This place yours?
Yep, all of it.
Wait until you see it finished.
Looks good.
I mean, hey, the race comments going to be more interesting than anything this movie actually brings up. You know they're not going to go there, but fuck it.
No, I'm just doing that to see if I can get to you.
Oh.
You want a taste?
Hey, yo! 2 days, 1 more day.
Oh, there's still 2 whole days left.
We need that one more day. So we need the day off at this point.
Glass coconuts out to give it that morning frost look.
I love a morning frost. Or
what?
Fresh snow.
I love a morning frost.
Hey, yo. It's okay. I'll give you a morning frost. Just come over to me in bed. Oh, we can make it happen.
You are the one who makes the dirty joke on this. It's great.
Always put up some pictures on the mantle.
Oh, this is a whole waste of time. We're just like trashing this movie.
I really hate how he's wearing the same pants as I am. That makes me feel angry.
Sure.
I mean, you're wearing like khakis. It's not an uncommon kind of pants.
I know.
Yeah, same as that color too. Nice. Oh, you get twins.
Like
twins, man.
I love how this place is coming together.
It'll be funny if it ends dark, like she just goes away and has fun and leaves him not even think about him. make this whole hour 20 minutes.
No, what they should do is they should have the dramatic like thing where she go where she almost gets on a plane, but she stops and he confesses his love to her at the airport. But then like a terror shows up and just explodes and kills her right in front of him.
Your mind goes so dark, bro.
This movie brings the worst on me. I'm sorry.
Bonsoir. Oh. Of course, getting stopped at the last minute.
You two aren't even antagonists. You barely said anything while you were here. You're the worst pathetic excuses for villains I've ever seen. You literal wastes of space.
Be over already. Be done. I want to be done with you. God, you just keep going. This felt like 3 hours you've been in his seat, but it's only been like an hour.
I feel like...
Yes, with the owl mark. Yes, 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 yes.
But I love it. Great job. Oh, and Taylor, I'm going to be sorry to see you go. But the board met and it's official.
Yep, I told you the worst possible way.
Gee, it's almost like it's very predictable. It has been done a million goddamn times before.
Adam, I was going to tell you.
Tell me what?
We need to talk.
Why? You're not even a couple yet.
You're not together. You owe him nothing.
Yeah. It's like, oh, hey, I'm moving to Paris, bitch. Bye. And commercial break.
Wow.
Boy, those commercials were nice. Way better than anything this movie has to fucking offer.
So,
because women can't be satisfied with a job. They need old school traditional men, the guy thinks. Because calm work classic sexism.
After all, Santa's got a lot of places to visit this year, right?
Like home. Home is wherever you hang your Christmas stocking. You'll know in your heart when you found the
right person. Oh my God! Did you hear that line?
I love you.
I'm trying to unhear it.
She's the worst of all of the mother. She's had the most cringiest scenes in this fucking movie.
She's barely been in it, but it's so bad.
Ugh. Disgusting. Repulsive.
Asking me every day for the past week when
this movie's repulsive.
Wow. I promise. Who's repugnant?
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
This movie gets a half-shaven pubic hair.
Why would the hell did they bother establishing that three assistant characters that they weren't even going to actually do anything? For real.
Giant gingerbread house, snowman sanctuary.
That looks awful.
Yeah, what the fuck is it? A cardboard cutout.
Our second entry, the elf castle.
Lame.
Yeah, but those are throwaways.
Next, we have the Northern Tower.
Yeah.
This is really tall.
Lame.
Only one of these actually looks like a damn house. You all failed the assignment.
And now, may I present our final gingerbread house, a home for the holidays!
That's seriously what they called it. It's so boring and generic.
It does look better than all of them.
It is! It's the one that's actually had fucking never been to it.
It does not look houses. It looks like, I don't know.
Yeah, it looks like random shit you build in Minecraft is printed out in fucking real life.
Aw, sweetie. I have to.
Cause you need to get that
bag.
But I had
a great time.
Bye, I need to follow my dreams. Following my dreams means not adopting a kid, so fuck you.
No kid adoptions here, motherfucker.
Yeah. You and your dad just go stay here and die in a fire
Christmas.
Or something.
Okay, come on.
Merry Calm Christmas. Down.
I can't be. There is no calmness. I am filled with boredom, rage, and depression. That's all this movie has reduced me to.
Can we just skip to the fucking airport love scene?
Much of everything
airport love confession.
Can we skip to the night home when they just plow each other viciously in front of everyone inside the gingerbread house?
I miss you.
Yeah, we know what that's what it's leading to.
Christmas.
Yep.
I guess you'll be calling this a
gingerbread orgy.
Yes.
It's probably a porno movie out there. Call that gingerbread orgy.
Do you think there's porno parodies of Hallmark movies?
God, I hope not. Yeah, it was the goal when she left already, because she didn't see she'd even that night, right? So.
Oh, I'm sorry. I packed and left like hours ago, man. You really should have stopped me there and then when we saw each other last.
Thank goodness. I thought I missed.
Wendy. Yep, you missed it.
Is Taylor here?
Nope.
Sorry, Adam. I was just boxing up some of her things. She was in a hurry. She left for the airport a couple hours ago. Her flight's taking off any minute.
Calling about the left phalange.
Mm-hmm. There's a problem with the left phalange.
At this time, anyone requiring assistance or traveling with small children, please check in.
Just get this over with, please.
Come on, we're at the final stretch. Come on! Come on!
Excuse me, but the thing that just boarded forgot this.
Okay, so no dramatic scene at the airport. She's just going to come back. She's just going to knock on the door and she'll be there. Nope, they didn't have the budget for stuff there. Put it all up.
Crappy already as it is.
Yeah.
It's like a fucking doctor's office.
It's okay. You and I will. But first, we got to check out Santa's land.
Coming back, this is where we all belong at home for Christmas.
Yeah. Because going out, having fun, and having good experiences that build you up as a person, nah.
What are you doing here?
You just need to stay home and do the same old thing every year because fuck you.
I thought you'd left.
To the people that we love.
Yeah.
True love and happiness.
The true love and happiness of people who have no regards for your best interests.
I have been traveling so long, I forgot what home felt like.
Ugh.
And since I found it this week, why would I want to leave?
Fuck you.
What about your job?
My firm got the downtown redevelopment project. The mayor confirmed it, which means Linda will be needing someone to head it up. It'll be the biggest job I've ever done.
Oh, great. You have a whole another totally separate promotion lined up for you that I had no idea about until this very moment. Thanks. That is so how storytelling is done.
I am.
Great. Then you can come to my grand opening. Or reopening, I should say.
Excuse me?
Ray's Bakery is having a grand reopening as Ray and Adam's Bakery. I'll be handling the specialty pastries only. Wouldn't have happened without you.
Are you kidding? Adam, that's great. This calls for a celebration.
Then you better get your skates, because in this house, every Christmas day after we go to Santa's Landing, we hit the ice. But before we go this year, I think there's another tradition we should start.
Mistletoe.
And what's that?
Where the fuck did that come from? Oh my god!
The gingerbread gods willed into existence at this very moment.
What the fuck?
You gotta love it that when your shitty jokes become reality.
It looks like how bad that looked like.
Yeah, it looks awful.
I don't know where. I think there's another tradition.
With the music.
Get your hand off my shoulder, dude.
Look at that.
That's awful.
We've been waiting for this entire movie. My God.
They really put the romance in gingerbread romance.
Yeah, Nate, this movie puts the romance in gingerbread.
Taylor, you're here?
Yes.
Taylor, you're
here. How can't you not see her from up the steps?
She's blind in her left and right eyes.
Cool.
Come on, man.
End credits. Let's go, end credits. Let's go. Let's go, end credits. Let's go. Let's go, end credits. Yeah!
Oh! 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 Oh. This movie's perfect. It's very nuanced, depth characters, masterful acting, masterclass actually. Perfect cinematography, a lot of depth. Good use of Rembrandt. You're gonna break that.
This movie already broke me. It's only fair.
Yeah, just a wonderful movie. 95, obviously.
Yeah, truly one of the classics of our era. Top two films of all time between this and Beetlejuice Goes to the Hood. the two best movies ever.
Best action movie?
No.
About to say it.
I know there's two movies where the Leprechaun goes to the hood.
Cool. Yeah. This movie is disgustingly bad, fellas.
Yeah.
This is Hallmark Christmas movies for you. Thank God. Oh, I think I'm done talking about this. What do you feel about this movie?
I don't feel anything. there's no emotions left to feel. I've been everywhere with this movie. I've laughed at the hilarity of goofiness. I've been depressed by how low people's standards are. I've been angered by how much money was wasted making this. I have been befuddled that this concept even was approved. I've been through the emotional roller coaster of life that I am done. I've experienced everything. I am now deceased. Goodbye.
This movie so bad. What's your score?
My score is a rancid, putrid, dying Martian out of 10.
No, we're not doing out of 10. This is a Rotten Tomatoes scores.
Okay, a negative 5,000 out of 10.
It's not a 10. It's a percentage score.
Negative 5,000%.
Like how we do Rotten Tomatoes scores?
It is a 0.5%.
This gets a doo-doo crease in your underwear, doo-doo stains out of 100, you know.
Mm-hmm. Shit stains out. So stains out of 100. Gotcha.
Yeah, shit. This one just get shit stains in Breeze.
Mm-hmm. For everyone who had part in making it.
Yeah, this movie gets a torn off condom. This movie gets this movie gets groin sweats out of 100. You know.
He gets a kick to the groin, too.
Yep. So movie's everything bad. This mm-hmm. movie is shit. Dog shit. Poo-poo. Caca. Boo-boo caca. No Kelly Clarkson.
Mm-hmm. This movie is... Is...
This movie is... Death. Is depression out of 100.
Yes. This movie is the opposite of antidepressants. It's redepressants. I'm become deaf, destroyer of Hallmark.
This movie's the atom bomb.
Yeah. Okay, we're rambling. We're fucking rambling.
Yeah, I kind of want to be done with this video, guys.
Yeah.
Hopefully you're having a much better Christmas or holidays than we are.
I hope you enjoyed our suffering. Our suffering was for a reason and you got something out of it.
At least you got some entertainment out of this, out of our suffering.
You better like and fucking subscribe for that shit.
Jesus
Fuck Christ. You. Especially since we're doing another one.
Yeah, we're doing one more bad one.
We're doing another one of these.
Oh, yeah, we're going to space that out because I can't do it again.
Yeah, we're not doing more than two of these during the Christmas season is enough to kill a person legally, so no.
Yeah, we're definitely doing one more probably next week. Give us a couple days.
Yeah. Maybe I'll put that one out on Christmas. Who fucking knows?
I don't know. But, yeah, guys, see ya. Have a good holidays.
See ya. Peace.